You know, in Dante's Inferno, when he outlined the levels of hell, so Dante was trying to get to the bottom of what constituted evil, really, in this representation. So it's a work of psychology, and he was thinking, well, there are various ways to behave reprehensibly, but there's a hierarchy of reprehensible behavior, and there's something absolutely the worst at the bottom. And Dante believed that it was betrayal. And I think that's right, because, you know, one of the things that enables long-term cooperation, peaceful cooperation between people is trust. And I would also say that trust is the fundamental natural resource. There's been some very good books written on the economic utility of trust, for example, and societies where the default economic presupposition between trading partners is trust tend to be rich, even if they don't have any natural resources. And you can see that, for example, with what happened with eBay, which I think was a kind of miracle, because what should have happened with eBay was that you sent me junk and I sent you a check that bounced, right? And that was the end of eBay. But right, exactly. But that isn't what happened. Like the default transaction on eBay was so honest that the brokers, you could hire brokers to begin with. I can't remember what they were called exactly, but you could pay someone a fee so that they would guarantee the transaction. So, you know, you wouldn't send me junk and I'd actually send you a payment and we'd pay 10% for someone to guarantee that. The default trade was so honest that those things vanished right away. And so that meant that all this frozen capital, roughly speaking, which were all the junk that people had lying around that someone else might want, instantly became money. And the only reason that worked was because people trusted one another. And so trust is an unbelievably powerful economic force, maybe the most powerful economic force. Anyways, if you have a relationship with someone, it's predicated on trust. And part of the reason for that is that trust is what enables us to look at each other without running away screaming. And what I mean by that is that if I trust you, then I don't have to take into account how complicated you are, because you're horribly complicated. You know, I think chimpanzee full of snakes, that's what a human being is. And as long as you'll do what you say you'll do, then I can take you at your word, and your word simplifies you, and you can take me at my word, and my word simplifies you, and then we can act like we understand each other, even though we don't. But then if that trust is betrayed, then all the snakes come forth very, very rapidly. And so all of you, I suspect, have been betrayed one way or another. And so what happens, if you're in a relationship with someone and you trust them, then you make certain assumptions about the past, and you make certain assumptions about the present, and you make certain assumptions about the future. And everything's stable, and so you're standing on solid ground. And the chaos, it's like you're standing on thin ice. The chaos is hidden. The shark beneath the waves isn't there. You're safe. You're in the lifeboat.